There's a holdup in the Bronx. Brooklyn's broken out in fights. There's a traffic jam in Harlem that's backed up to Jackson Heights. There's a scout troop short a child. Cruise ships do an idle wild.
Car 54, where are you?
Next time, steal something lighter.
This way.
I know the way.
Van Cleve, for the last time, I believe you. You say he's your son, he's your son. But in the eyes of the police department, he's a dog, and a dog needs a license. Now, please, fill this out.
How about it, fellas? I just got one ticket left for the big raffle. Only 50 cents.
Is that raffle still going on?
Look, we can't have a drawing for the grand prize until I sell the last ticket. How about it?
Look, I already bought six, Toody.
How about you, Dennis? For only 50 cents, you can win a valuable prize.
Get somebody else.
Get somebody else. That's the spirit you have. No wonder the Brotherhood Club is always in debt.
We're in debt because you're the treasurer.
Look, fellas, we need the money for this raffle to pay off the loss from the 4th of July excursion trip to Bear Mountain.
And you organized the excursion trip to pay off the Memorial Day picnic in Central Park.
That was a fiasco. You forgot to get a permit.
Could happen to anybody.
Oh, no, it could only happen to you, Toody. Come on.
Oh, hey, Leo. How about a ticket for the big prize? 50 cents, you're going to a valuable prize.
Look who he's asking. Look who he's asking. The unluckiest man in the world, he's asking to buy a raffle ticket.
Well, maybe this time you'll win.
Me win? In my entire life, I won one thing. The hand of my wife. Some prize, huh?
It's only 50 cents. This may change your luck.
Luck? This is a word that isn't in the vocabulary of the Schnauzer family. Just before I was born, a black cat must have run in front of my mother when she was walking under a ladder. And you know when I was born? Are you ready? Friday the 13th. And you're gonna change my luck.
Leo, this is for the Brotherhood Club.
All right, here's 50 cents. I'd probably spend it on a pizza, get poisoned, and wind up in a hospital.
Yeah, I'll write out your name on this stuff. You hold this ticket.
Keep it, tear it up, throw it away.
No, you gotta hold it.
All right, I'll take it. I'll paste it on my wall with the rest of the sweepstakes tickets, the stocks I bought, and the thank you note from Nixon.
Coming, Gunther?
Wait just a second.
Muldoon, here's an eviction notice. It's in your sector.
Yes, sir. Carpathia, just one name?
He's one of those modern artists. Who knows what his name is? Who can tell what he paints? All I know is he's living in a loft in violation of the building code. See that he gets out.
Does it look like trouble, Captain?
If it was trouble, would I send you to? Well, I'll get going.
Come in. Ah, the Cossacks are here. The barbarians have entered the Temple of Art. Welcome.
Mr. Carpathia, we have to serve you this.
I know. The Philistines, the ignorant of one another battle.
Mr. Carpathia, they're doing it for your own good. It's not safe here.
I understand. But the world doesn't understand. They don't understand that when a man pours his mind, his heart onto a canvas, and then they cannot... Yeah, look who I'm talking to.
Mr. Carpathia, can we help you pack your paintings?
Don't touch it. Don't touch a single one with your grubby policeman's hand.
Yes, sir. Mr. Carpathia, we have to stay here till you get out.
So stay.
Do you mind if we look around?
You want to look around. So look around.
The window, stupid.
Hey, Francis, look at this one.
Quiet. Don't laugh. You'll hurt his feelings.
What do you mean? Gee, I like this painting. It's terrific. You know what this reminds me of? When we're coming from fishing in New Jersey and we're sitting in the ferry. This looks exactly like Lower Manhattan around sunset. Yeah, that's just how it looks, with those tall buildings on Wall Street and these skyscrapers.
What did you say?
Don't mind him, Mr. Carpathia. He just babbles on.
Quiet! What did you say about my painting?
Well, I just said it looks like Lower Manhattan at sunset from the New Jersey side.
Look! That's what it says. Lower Manhattan at sunset from the New Jersey side. And you understood it.
I understood it. It's obvious.
Obvious! They've been decorated by kings. My paintings hang in museums, but this is the crowning point of my career. I've reached the people. It's yours.
Mine?
It's yours. That's the only way I can repay you.
Gee, thanks.
Oh, that must be the moving truck.
Hey, that's pretty nice of him, huh?
Gunther, you actually see Manhattan in that?
Not only Manhattan, I even see a little of Long Island on the other side.
Gunther, what are you doing home? I saw Francis outside in the car.
Well, I just had to drop something off at the house.
I went shopping and I just got...
Ah! Let me explain.
You don't have to explain. You got mad about having to take out the garbage every day, so you just threw it against the wall.
Look, Lucille, this is a beautiful picture.
What?
It's a work of art. Don't you understand it?
Do you?
It's obvious. That's Lower Manhattan at sunset.
That's Lower Manhattan at sunset?
From the New Jersey side. Not the window again.
Listen, America! My husband is a nut!
What are you yelling out windows?
I have to talk to a human being once in a while. Get that horrible thing out of this house.
Let it hang there just for a little while. You'll get used to it. I got used to you, didn't I?
What kind of...
I didn't mean it. Oh, that's a bold dude. Do what you want with it. I'll see you tonight.
Gunther and his junk. Well, Lower Manhattan, you're going into a garbage can in the Bronx.
I finally did it, Francis. From the money from the raffle, I paid off every cent from the last excursion trip, and it comes out exactly even.
You mean we haven't a cent in the treasury?
That's right, but we don't owe anything. We can start out fresh.
Gunther.
What?
The raffle drawing for the valuable prize is tomorrow, isn't it?
That's right.
What's the valuable prize?
It's, Ooh, I forgot all about it.
You better think of something. You better think of it quick.
Is there anything you can think of as a prize?
Gunther, you kept yelling valuable prize. Between the two of us, we haven't got anything valuable.
Gotta find him something. I'll see you tomorrow. It's my painting. She threw it out. Our troubles are over.
What do you mean?
Take this home and wrap it up nice like a prize.
Prize? You can't pass off this... this thing as a valuable prize.
Why not? It's a painting. They just sold a Rembrandt for $2.5 million. Let's tell them that this is worth $500,000.
Gunther, they'll kill you.
Are you kidding? They're all good sports.
What if Schnauzer wins?
Schnauzer? He won't win. You heard him. He never won a thing in his life. Here. Take this down to the station house tomorrow. We got nothing to worry about. So long, Fritz. All right, fellas, this is it. Schnauzer, where are you going? This is the drawing. In a few minutes, we're going to know the name of the winner of the valuable prize.
Hurry up, will you? Stop shaking and pick a name.
All right, all right. Here, Francis, pick a name. And who is the winner of the valuable prize?
I can't make it out. You read it.
All right, the winner is, you better read it, Francis. You got a clearer voice.
Come on, who is it?
Oh, come on, what's the name?
Come on, read it.
All right, all right.
Who won?
The winner is Leo Schnauzer.
Hey, Leo, you won!
I won! For the first time in my life, I won something. Me, Leo Schnauzer, I won. You did it, Toody. You said my luck would change. This is it. From now on, I'm going to the track. I'm going to Las Vegas on my vacation. I'm going to bet on the ball games. I have a new name, Lucky Leo. For the first time in my life, I won. Where's the prize?
Francis, give him the prize.
You give it to him. It's up there.
Well, it's too far high up there for me to reach. Now, you give it to him.
Oh, give him the prize.
Somebody give it to me.
Give him the prize.
Stop washing around.
Here you go, Leo.
I finally won. I won a prize.
Open it up. Come on,
Leo.
What is it?
This is what I won.
Listen, Leo.
This is the valuable prize.
Well, let me explain what it is.
Don't have to explain what it is. It's obvious. After all these years, I finally won a color picture of a tonsil operation. Fate has given it to old Schnauzer again. A valuable prize.
All paintings are valuable, and this one is in oil.
Sardines are in oil, too. Why didn't you get me a can of sardines? Sardines I can eat. What am I going to do with this? Hang it up and scare the mice out of the apartment?
You're unhappy.
Who's unhappy? It's something I've always wanted.
Oh, then you understand it, too.
Understand what?
That this is Lower Manhattan at sunset.
This is Lower Manhattan at sunset?
From the New Jersey side.
Oh, from the New Jersey side.
Can't you see it?
I don't drink.
Look, it's obvious. You see, there. There's the Empire State Building.
Keep him away from me. Keep this kook away from me. Somebody sits on a pizza pie, they put a frame around it, and to him, it's Lower Manhattan at sunset. From the New Jersey side, yeah.
Now, wait a minute, Leo. Gunther was in a spot.
I'm sorry. There was no money left for a prize. If you don't want it...
I'll take it. My wife has been yelling for a frame. She'll get a frame.
You're a good sport, Leo.
I'm a good sport. Lucky Leo is a good sport.
See? I told you, Francis. Everything turned out all right.
Come on, let's get dressed and go home.
Yes?
Is this the home of Mr. Gunther Toody?
Yes, won't you come in?
Oh, thank heavens, I found him. I'm Boyden Pennington, the director of the Modern Museum of Abstract Art.
Oh, really? My sister and I have been there twice.
Naturally, being the wife of such a connoisseur of art as Mr. Gunther Toody.
Gunther, a connoisseur?
Mrs. Toody, we are pressed for time. You see, tonight we are holding the opening of our most important exhibition, The Works of Carpathia.
Carpathia?
Yes, and it wouldn't be complete without the masterpiece which we understand is in Mr. Toody's collection.
Mr. Toody's collection? I think there must be some mistake.
A mistake? Well, it's in the catalog of Mr. Carpathia's work. See here, Autumn Fantasy on loan from Nelson Rockefeller, Riddle in Red, owned by the Cleveland Museum, Lower Manhattan at Sunset, from the collection of Gunther Toody.
From the collection of Gunther Toody?
Now, Mrs. Toody, we have no time to lose. I'm sure Mr. Toody will permit us to show the painting. I have men downstairs who will transport it.
Well, actually, that's impossible.
Impossible, but it's only a loan.
Well, you see, my husband doesn't want it out of his sight.
But it would only be for a week, and it would be fully insured for its estimated value of $25,000.
$25,000?
Yes, once it's seen at the exhibit. That is a conservative estimate.
And I threw it out.
I beg your pardon?
I said it's out. It's out of the question.
But, Mrs. Toody...
Really, I'm afraid you'll have to go now. I'm not feeling too well.
But, Mrs. Toody... Of course. Mrs. Toody, I beg of you, see if you can persuade your husband to part with the painting. Please.